Hello everyone, thank you for being here today. I'm Skjuhi from CES IT department. So I'm here today to talk to you about the blockchain technology. At first, I'm going to tell you that what is blockchain. Blockchain is a technology of storage and transmission of information. On the other hand, we can say that blockchain is a decentralized list of all transactions across a peer-to-peer network. Blockchain is the technology underlying Bitcoin. Suppose a very large notebook which everyone can read freely for free, on which everyone can write, which is impossible to erase and indestructible. Now we are going to know about how blockchain works. The blockchain technology facilitates peer-to-peer transactions without any intermediaries such as a bank or a government body. At its core, the blockchain is essentially a database of all transactions happening in the network. The database is public and therefore not owned by any other party. It is distributed, that it is not stored in any one computer that is owned by somebody. Instead, it is stored in many computers across the world. The database is constantly synchronized to keep the transaction up to date, and it is secured by the art of cryptography, making it hacker-proof. These four features make this an exception technology. Blockchain works as a network of computer in case of Bitcoin cryptography. It is used to be transaction secure and causes among those in the network. After the transaction is validated, the details of a transfer are recorded on a public ledger that anyone on the network can see. Let's understand the blockchain technology with more details by looking at the example of how a transaction happens using Bitcoin. Anybody can download simple piece of software and install it to their computer to use Bitcoin. Because it is a decentralized peer-to-peer system, you do not need to register an account in any particular company or hand over any personal details. Once you have a wallet, you can create address which is effectively become your identity within the network. Let's see, here party A wants to send money to party B in the form of Bitcoins. This is a transaction which will eventually change the Bitcoin balances for both party A and B. The form section is collected in a and record all the Bitcoin transactions. The parties in the network approves that the transaction is valid through a process called mining. The miners are issued a certain number of Bitcoin in exchange for doing this work. Once a transaction is approved, the new block is added to the blockchain, which is a ledger of all the post-transaction. Now we are going to know how blockchain affects bank. Bank traditionally held the role of intermediaries, however blockchain eliminates third parties in all transactions. Banks, however, don't feel threatened anymore. Instead, they are finding innovative ways to apply blockchain in banking. For example, speedy execution of security settlement, and another example is reduce the capital requirements for bank. Here are some possible uses for blockchain, like banking, markets, selling music, property records, medical records, smart contracts, voting, and etc. So here is a simple example, so that you can understand it easily.
Car companies make leasing look easy, but in reality, it can be quite complicated. A significant challenge faced by today's car leasing networks is that even though the physical supply chain is usually integrated, the supporting information systems are often fragmented. Imagine a world where every participant in this network could monitor, access, and share consistent and up-to-date information, irrespective of where the vehicle is in its life cycle. Imagine one agreed view of the complete vehicle history, and how this would improve service, warranty, and/or recall costs. By providing an agreed, shared record of vehicle information, as it's transferred across the supply chain, blockchain solutions from IBM can deliver just that. Let's take a look at how this would work. The government regulator creates and populates the registration for the new vehicle, which is loaded onto the blockchain. The smart contract ensures that only the regulator can do this. The regulator then transfers ownership of the vehicle to the manufacturer by invoking a transaction on the blockchain. The transaction is verified if all relevant parties agree. This is referred to as consensus, and it's made efficient through blockchain usage. IBM blockchain allows the validation method to be tailored to meet the needs of the business network. The manufacturer adds the make, model, and vehicle identification number to the vehicle template, again, as permitted by the smart contract. This update is visible to all members of the supply chain with the right permission. For example, dealerships in the network can see the new stock availability. The vehicle can then be transferred to the dealership on execution of a smart contract of sale. Again, the transaction is verified if all relevant parties agree and the vehicle template on the blockchain updated for all members of the network with appropriate permissions to see. After the vehicle is transferred to the leasing company, a lessee can finally lease the car. This synchronized process continues across the supply chain as the car passes to the end user and eventually to the scrap merchant who, as governed by the smart contract, has permission to dispose of the vehicle at the end of its life. At all stages, the security, integrity, and validity of vehicle information is assured using proven cryptographic services. With IBM blockchain, you will be able to reduce the processing time to minutes instead of days. Since all the data is now stored in a secure, distributed ledger, all members of the supply chain never have to worry about vehicle information inconsistencies, leading to increased efficiencies, improved resilience with mitigation from cybersecurity and fraud risks. And not just that, IBM blockchain will significantly bring down the processing costs by reducing the overhead associated with intermediaries.
Thank you so much for your valuable time.